Hello and welcome to this lesson plan for an introduction to the Revit user interface. In this lesson, we will explore the contextual ribbon tabs in Revit. This is video 2 of 5 in this series. My name is John Herridge, and I will be your host today for this lesson. Now let's look at the learning objectives for video 2. In this exercise, we will explore ways of accessing tools within Revit related to specific tasks through contextual ribbon tabs. In this exercise, we will look at 2 specific examples. The first example is applying a filter to an existing selection set in the canvas window for model-based objects. And in the second example, we'll take a look at creating a similar model-based component from an existing selection set. Let's get started. Please open the file Revit Intro Exercise 2. The Contextual Ribbon tab appears when you use certain tools or select elements. A Contextual Ribbon tab displays tools that relate to the context of that tool or element. The tab closes when you exit the tool or clear the selection set. You can specify whether a contextual tab automatically comes into focus or the current tab stays in focus. You can also specify which ribbon tab displays when you exit a tool or clear a selection. To get a feel for how contextual ribbon tabs work, let's first practice on a single model category in the drawing model. Go ahead and please open the Level 1 floor plan view. Go ahead and zoom in if you want. And let's go ahead and select one of the interior walls in the building model. It doesn't matter which one. Now note that when a single object category is selected in the canvas window, then the contextual ribbon tab for walls appears above the canvas window. Any tools that are not grayed out can be used to perform that task. This ends the practice example. Please hit the modify or the escape key twice to cancel the current selection set. Now on to the first learning objective. We want to make a window size change to all the windows in the model. We will start this process by accessing the filter tool through a contextual tab. The filter tool can be used as a means for narrowing the categories within a selection set that you wish to work with. So if you would, go ahead and window select the entire model to create a singular selection set. And then in the contextual ribbon, you'll see on the far right hand side there is a filter tool. Just go ahead and select that. And we just want to keep the windows category, so please unmark doors and walls category. And then select the OK button to continue. And then move over to the Properties palette, and we will go ahead and substitute a new size for the current locations of the windows. So in that list for fixed windows, go ahead and select fixed 24 by 48, and instantaneously the new size is populated across the selection set. All right, go ahead and cancel the current selection set and we'll move on to objective number 2. For this next example, we want to place a new door in the model based upon an existing door in place. We can achieve this result by using a command called create similar located in a contextual ribbon tab. Go ahead and please select one of the exterior doors in the model. And then on the contextual ribbon tab in the create panel, go ahead and choose create similar. And just confirm that what the door size is that it's referring to. And then go ahead and locate an instance of the new door at this location shown. Dimensions are not specific. All right, select the modify button to end the command. And let's take a look at an alternative way for accessing Create Similar. If you reselect one of the doors on screen and then right click in the canvas window, you can also access the Create Similar command. So you have two ways of getting access to that. All right. This concludes this exercise. Go ahead and save the file as Revit Intro Exercise 2 finished. And let's look at next steps. In review of this lesson, we were able to apply a filter to a model-based selection set. And then the second objective was to create a similar model-based component from a selection set. So these are very common tasks that you would perform through the development of a Revit project. Let's look at next steps, and specifically, let's take a look at Autodesk resources that are available to you. I would like to make you aware of two specific Autodesk resources. The first one being the Autodesk Education Community, where you can access free software for both students and educators, and that can be located at www.students.autodesk.com. It does require registration, and you can use either your own personal email address or a school-issued email address. The second resource is the Autodesk Digital STEAM Workshop. It's hands-on, project-based learning across multiple industries such as architecture, engineering, gaming, and animation. And those resources are located at www.digitalsteam.autodesk.com. This concludes this exercise. Thank you very much for watching.